Hello, my name is Till Kleinert. I'm the writer and director of the German feature-length film Der Samurai, which is premiering at Frightfest in just a couple minutes. What else do you want to know?
I think what people probably want to know is what the film's all about and what made you want to tell this story.
I will try to keep this brief. I mean, Der Samurai is a weird little horror thriller set in the German countryside, rural area, very forested, close to the Polish border. And it's about a young policeman living in one of these villages who stumbles upon one night a strange character who is roaming the forests around the village, a slender young man wearing a woman's dress and sporting a katana, a samurai sword. So it becomes his agenda over the course of the night to sort of stop him from wreaking havoc, which he is about to. And over the course of that, I think many of the notions of order and of morality that our cop has are being quite challenged by this stranger. And Jakob, our hero, he will not be the same after the events of that night.
Talk a little bit about casting the film.
Yeah, well, I mean, the actor who plays the samurai, who has been favorably compared to Klaus Kinski already, which is a real honor, I think, for him and for me as well. I have shot a short film with him before in 2007, and it was pretty clear to me that he should also be the guy playing this iconic character, the samurai. You can see it when you will see him soon. You can see his face. It's very special, very specific, and he has a very rock starish quality to him, which I really like to capture in a film. And for our main character Jakob, it was the challenge was to find someone who is quite the opposite, but still has a way to keep up with this guy. So someone who's quite soft and unfinished and innocent, but still has the depths to sort of cross over to the other side over the course of the film. And I think we found a wonderful actor with young Michel Dix who plays that guy.
Yeah. Of course, we're here at Frightfest celebrating the horror genre.
Yes.
What do you think it gives filmmakers and audiences that they perhaps don't get from other types of cinema?
Oh, well, I think it's like, you know, like at Halloween, putting on a mask. It gives you some sort of freedom it liberates you to say and do things that you normally wouldn't, to address things and to address issues you wouldn't normally address, maybe because you would be afraid, like death, like also repressed sexuality, like stuff like that. And I think it's almost like pop music. To me, it's very similar. Like pop music gives you the opportunity to dance, and dancing is a very liberating act, you know. And so I think also a cinema that is more about the physicality and about liberating your thoughts and your actions is something that's very good and healthy for people. So yeah, I think I like the transgressive sides, the transgressiveness about it, and I think it's good to face these things that we usually don't dare to face.
Is there a particular horror film that's left a special impression, had an impact on you?
There are many. I think one of my favorite horror films ever is The Wicker Man, the British original one, because I think it's cool because it's not a scary film actually at all, and because I think it's a very narrow view of horror cinema. If you just think that horror films are the films that scare you personally, I think horror films are films that deal with horrific expressions of inner turmoil or something. But they don't necessarily need to be scary. They can also be very weird and very funny. And I think The Wicker Man is both, and I really like that. And I also like how it addresses themes of like sexual liberty, liberation against this very uptight, this very uptight, what you say when you are, it's with P, it's something with P. This uptight policeman, it's not policeman. Policeman is not the word I was looking for. But so it's just, that's what I like about it anyway.